Hello everyone, welcome back to our physics class. Hope all of you are safe and sound over there. In the previous session we had discussed about the electric potential due to electric dipole. Also we discussed an expression to find out the work done in rotating this dipole in an external electric field. Today we will discuss an important concept of this chapter, that is equipotential surface. We will discuss more about this equipotential surface and its properties. So let's get started with today's session. Children, let's discuss about equipotential surface. From the name itself, it's very clear. Equipotential surface is a surface where the potential will be equal or same at all points. So consider a point charge Q located here. Consider a point A at a distance of r from Q. Consider a point B at a distance of same distance r from Q. Similarly, consider all other points lying at the same distance from the charge Q. Let's calculate the potential at these points. Consider the point A. What is the potential at the point A? It is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R. R is the distance. What is the potential at B? It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R, because here also B is at the same distance R from the charge Q. And what will be the potential at the point C? It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R. And if we calculate potential at the remaining points, it will be the same, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R. Okay. And if we join all the points, you will get a surface. And this surface is in the form of sphere. And this sphere is an equipotential surface. Why? Because the potential at any point on this sphere is same. So the shape of equipotential surface for a point charge is sphere. Okay. Now what do you think? Can there be only one equipotential surface for a point charge? Let's discuss. So we have already seen, for a point charge there will be one equipotential surface. So suppose this is one equipotential surface and the radius of that equipotential surface is r. Now consider another point P, which is at a distance of r1 from the charge Q. Another point Q, which is lying at the same distance r1 from Q. Similarly, consider other points lying at the same distance from the charge Q. Okay, now what will be the potential at these points? Consider the point P. What will be the potential here? It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r1, because r1 is the distance between the point P and the charge now. And what will be the potential at Q? It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r1. So if we calculate potential at the remaining points, it will be same, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r1. And if we join all the points, we will get another sphere. This sphere is also an equipotential surface as far as this plus Q charge is concerned, because the potential created on the surface of the sphere is due to this plus Q charge kept at the center of that sphere. Okay, so two equipotential surfaces are possible for this point charge. Not only two, many number of equipotential surfaces are possible like this. Now what do you think? How much work is required to move a charge from one point to another point on this equipotential surface? So for that, consider a point A and consider another point B on the equipotential surface. A and B are lying at the same distance from the charge Q. The distance is r. Now what is the potential at A? The potential at A is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r. What is the potential at B? It will be V equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by r. Suppose we want to move a plus 1 coulomb charge, that means a unit positive charge, from the point A to the point B. So how much work is done? And we had already studied one expression, work done per unit charge is equal to potential difference. Potential difference is V final minus V initial, which is the initial point here A, which is the final point here B. So our potential difference will be VB minus VA, right? So what is work? Work done is equal to Q into VB minus VA, right? And Q is, yes, our charge is plus 1 coulomb because we are moving a unit positive charge from A to B. We are not discussing about this charge kept at the center. We are discussing about the unit positive charge which is moved from the point A to the point B. So it is 1 into VB minus VA. What is this VB minus VA? VB minus VA is equal because potential at A is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. Potential at B is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. So VA is equal to VB. So VB minus VA will be equal to 0. So work done will be 0. This means work done to move a charge from one point to another point on an equipotential surface is 0. Okay. Now, I told you many number of equipotential surfaces are possible for a point charge or for any charge. Okay. So here, what do you think? Whether the potentials of all the equipotential surfaces will be same? So let's check. Here this is the potential. Let the potential of this first equipotential surface be V1. Let the potential of the second sphere or the second equipotential surface be V2. Let the potential of the third equipotential surface be V3. And let the potential of the fourth equipotential surface be V4. Now, this first sphere is lying at a distance of R or R1. Let it be R1 from the charge Q. And the second sphere is lying at a distance of R2 from the charge Q. Third is lying at a distance of R3 from the charge Q. Fourth sphere is lying at a distance of R4 from the charge Q. So now what will be the potential for the first sphere? Or what will be the potential at any point on the first sphere? Let it be V1. V1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R1. And what will be the potential V2? V2 will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R2. Similarly, V3 equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R3. And similarly, V4 equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R4. Right? And here, the potential for the different equipotential surfaces is not same, it's different. Okay, because V1 is not equal to V2, is not equal to V3, is not equal to V4. So which will be greater and which will be smaller? So here, for that we need to consider the distance, because all other factors are same. The Q by 4 pi epsilon naught factor is same for all the potential expression, and what is different? Only the distance is different. Here the distance is R1, here it is R2, here it is R3, here it is R4. And potential is inversely proportional to this distance. So as distance increases, potential decreases. Here, this first equipotential surface or the first sphere is lying very close to the charge Q. That means the distance R1 is less. So potential will be more. So V1 is greater than all other potentials. Then V1 is greater than V2, greater than V3, greater than V4. So V4 is least because, yes, it is that equipotential surface is lying at a greater distance from the charge Q. So as distance increases, potential decreases. So the potential V4 is least, the potential V1 is the maximum one. So the different equipotential surfaces will have different values for potential. But if we consider any point on a particular equipotential surface, potential on those points will be same. Okay. Now, what do you think about the direction of electric field with respect to equipotential surface? So, for that, we must mark the electric field line for this particular charge. Since this is a plus Q charge and also it's a point charge, what is the shape of or what is the direction of electric field lines? It will be pointing radially outwards like this, right? So this is the direction of electric field lines for a point charge. Now, if we consider its angle with respect to the equipotential surface, what is that? If we consider the first equipotential surface, this is the surface and this is the field line, so angle is 90 degree. If we consider the second equipotential surface and the field line, angle is 90. If we consider the third surface and the field line, it is 90. Here also it is 90. Here also it is 90. It is 90 like this. Okay, the surface angle between this particular surface and electric field line. So from this it is very clear electric field is perpendicular to equipotential surface. Okay, electric field is perpendicular to equipotential surface. The angle between electric field and equipotential surface is 90 degrees.